Come on in, mate. Sean? Sean, come on in, mate.
Can we do another take?
No, you come on in, mate. Good on you, Sean. Well done.
We're all off. Lovely to meet you.
You're off.
See you later.
Bye.
Great to meet you. I hope you get more of those ads. Those snooze, Captain. That was awesome, man. I love them. And more.
I'm just going to grab a coffee. Do you want to just come down to reception and
maybe
get a cab?
Yeah. What about, are we going to do that?
I'll just grab a coffee.
Kevin, sorry, just wondering if we can get your opinion on Shaun. How do you think he went today? Given that, you know, it's a first go and all that, no training whatsoever.
There was a guy once who was worse than Shaun. I did a job at Triple M and he had one line. I was doing a job for an electrical store that had the hook that, you know, at the start of every ad, there was this window smashing. And this one guy, this DJ from Triple M, had to say one line, and that was, "What was that?" And every time, you know, the window smashed, he'd go, "What was that?" And, you know, the engineer would try and encourage him, try and put him in the space where an actor had to be by saying, "Now you're just outside the window, a brick comes through the window, it's a big smash, what are you doing?" And he'd go, "What was that?" Anyway, we tried to actually just get him to mimic us, going, "What was that?" But time after time, I was just, "What was that?" And I ended up doing the voiceover myself, but his line myself. But I guess, yes, he'd be one person who's probably worse than Shaun. No, you know what? On reflection, Shaun's worse than him. Sorry. By the way, that bloke's running Triple M now, and I haven't worked there since.
Oh, sorry, mate. We're just wondering if we can get your impression of Shaun. How do you think he went?
Oh,
sorry to catch you at this moment.
Yeah, look, he was okay. I wouldn't say he's the worst person I've ever worked with, but and there was a guy once that I was doing a job with, and he was actually a store Santa. They brought him in to play Santa in this job, and it was a 30-second track, and I had the other part, and we couldn't bring it in under 48 seconds. So eventually they said, "Thanks a lot, mate. We'll see you again sometime." And he left, and they got me to do both voices. So I ended up playing Santa and this other character. Actually, on reflection, Shaun was worse than that. And that guy's now running Myers.
Abby, I was wondering if I could just get your opinion on Shaun. How do you think he went today?
Is he going to see it?
No, this is going to be submitted to something else.
Bloody hell. I tell you what, it was exhausting because I think the thing is, and you know what's amazing to me, is that the guy actually had quite a good demo. Now, I've heard this has happened before to me, you know, when somebody's had a good demo and then you kind of get them in the studio situation and they don't know what to do, they're intimidated by the situation. And you know, I think he was a little bit uncomfortable. I know that, you know, when you haven't done it before, being in the studio behind a microphone can be a little bit intimidating. But he just, I don't know, it just makes me think more and more that doing voiceovers is, you sound like you're up yourself when you say this, but not everyone can do it, you know, it's a specialist kind of thing. And I don't know what it is, but it's a way of thinking into the script and lifting the words off the page and making it real, and he hasn't got it. He just hasn't got it. I mean...
Well, thanks for your honesty.
That's okay. Yeah. He could get it. But
with a bit of help, maybe.
But what's got me absolutely confused is how he did that amazing demo. He was gorgeous and so versatile. Anyway, I've got to run.
Okay.
So thanks very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
See ya.
I wasn't picking it. It was just like I got an itch. I get an itchy nose sometimes. It's like hay fever season. It seems to happen to me when I'm driving all the time. And I've been driving along, having a scratch, and someone next to me is like looking at me like the, like I just raped their kelpie. It's just scratch, mate.
So you just want to say good day for me and tell me who you are and what you do?
Okay. G'day. I'm Shaun Wayne. And what was the other thing?
What do you do, Shaun?
Oh, I, G'day. I'm Shaun Wayne. And I hope to coach cricket soon. I did a little bit of landscaping design with my old mate Chooker. He has a mate that runs a studio, so I went in and did a voiceover gig, which was really cool. That was with Kevin Harrington. He's a top bloke, I tell you. He's not half as evil as he seems in Underbelly. That guy from Captain Snooze ads, he was there, and it was like that bloke with the really long, Abby Holmes. She was a sweetheart. She was really, made me feel welcome. I think it was an ad for barbecues or something. They were going to give me a copy, but because they don't have email, they said they'd send it, but they haven't yet. I train, I practice, because I need to get my coaching qualification. I'm a bit confused why I can't coach until I get a certificate, but I'm going to get a certificate as soon as the police check and the children thing goes through. They just had a few little problems with that, something from overseas, but that won't matter. There was a little incident in Amsterdam where I kind of tried to fly and may have sent some texts to the wife of the president wearing nothing but cricket pads and a helmet. But I maintain that I wasn't quite in my normal state of mind at that point. And hopefully they will maintain that. You know, I'm a man of convictions, and nothing was ever proven, so it'll be okay. I'm not very good at selling myself because I tried to do that once when I was really, really short of cash, and to be honest, it wasn't much fun. I thought, I'm embarrassed to say this, I thought, you know, there'd be a whole lot of rich widows and stuff, but it was just really rich weirdos, and they were all blokes. And I didn't do anything. I said I tried. But I can't sell myself better than that, I'm afraid. Should I give them my number, or...?
We can do that at the end.
Cool. If you're watching this and you want someone to work with you, see, I said with, not for, please have perspective. When you see me, realise that I am who I am. We are all in need of perspective. Sometimes there's too much, sometimes there's not enough. But I need your love as much as you need me. When you employ Shaun Wayne, you get all of me. You get everything that's inside and hangs out. I am a good employee. Don't listen to what anyone says, except me. That almost rhymed. Maybe I could rap sometime, I don't know. How much time we got? Because I could write something.
Yeah, I think we've pretty much got it. Thanks, Shaun.
No worries. Can I use the toilet? I'm a bit...
Yeah, it's just off.
Thanks. I had one of those curries last night.
Mate, this is tragic. Yeah, it's not as bad as what's happening in Queensland, but I'll tell you what, the amount of water here, just under here, one of the best pitches ever. One of the best pitches I ever played on. Scored a lot of runs, got a lot of wickets. Holds a lot of memories for me. I remember the day as if it was yesterday when the concrete truck came in and laid the slab. And then when they stuck that green stuff on top, there was a crack I used to use whenever I was bowling my spin. I'd somewhere. Oh, jeez. Guess it's going to be a bit bigger now. It's all right. Jeez, that really went in, didn't it? Does concrete shrink when it's wet? Maybe it wasn't here. It was somewhere here anyway.
Yeah, it's not all bad, mate. I mean, I used to get really annoyed with the paparazzi, but they haven't followed me around for about 10 years now, so it was kind of fun. That Amsterdam incident and, you know, what happened in England and then what happened in South Africa and Zimbabwe and, yeah. But I'll tell you what, I need a break. I mean, I love this place. I love this country, but fires, floods, Queensland, Victoria. Oh, God. I've got to get away. I mean, I'm hanging to get back into coaching. Well, not back, but I'm hanging to start coaching cricket. As soon as I get my qualification when it comes through, I will, but I need a break first. And thank God for my mum. I mean, she's great. You know, she goes through and circles all the jobs and all the places that I could move to. But she found an ad for, I don't know, this place in New Zealand, Napier. I don't know, so I'm going for a week. I think it's a week. Anyway, mum bought the ticket, gave it to me, got my passport. I think she's driving me to the airport too. It don't matter. Just get away. Just get away. Have some fun for a week. I need a break. Do you want a coffee? It's good. I'm drinking soy milk now because I used to get really bad gas from the dairy. Actually, I got really bad gas from dairy, wheat, fruit, vegetables, meat, cornflakes, water, coffee, and what's that other thing? Spaghetti. They all seem to give me really bad gas. Doesn't matter if you're single.
Psst. Wakey, wakey.